Je me baladais sur l'avenue, le cœur ouvert à l'inconnu. J'avais envie de dire bonjour à n'importe qui.
Bonjour tout le monde, c'est moi encore Madame Audrey. Je suis ici pour vous enseigner la langue française de manière simple. Good day everyone, this is Madame Audrey. I'm here to teach you French in a more simplified way. This is Language House International. Presenting to you Simplified French with Mildred. Okay, so today we're going to be treating a very interesting topic, a very bright topic. The title of the topic is Les couleurs, which means colors. So we're going to be treating colors in French. Listen attentively. Merci beaucoup.
Je me baladais sur l'avenue, le cœur ouvert à l'inconnu. J'avais envie de dire bonjour à n'importe qui.
Bonjour tout le monde, c'est moi encore Madame Mildred. I'm here to treat a new and a very wonderful topic titled Les couleurs and les vêtements. So les couleurs means colors and les vêtements means what? Clothing. Okay, so please listen to this interesting and wonderful topic. Remember that colors are adjectives, okay? So you know what an adjective is, they qualify, okay, a noun. And also, please take note of this, that adjectives in French, they, you know, work with numbers and genders, okay? That's concerning the noun that is qualifying, okay? So please take note of that as we go on. That's why we have, and also we have the masculine and the feminine colors, okay? So if the word, the noun is masculine, then we use masculine of the colors. Then if the noun is also feminine, we use the feminine of the colors, okay? Using la and lo, okay? Merci beaucoup, écoutez très bien. Le blanc, la blanche. That's called white. Bleu, la bleue. That's what color blue. Le vert, la verte. That's color green. Le rouge, la rouge. That's color red. Okay, you can see because you already have E at the end. Because one of the ways we identify, you know, the feminine words, most of the time they end with words E. So we already have E in the masculine and we have E also in the feminine. Okay, so there's no need of changing it by adding E. Okay, so now we have jeune, la jeune, le jeune. Okay, now we have, which is yellow. Now we have l'orange, l'orange. Take note that we have L with an apostrophe because orange is starting with a vowel. Okay, take note of that. And it's also ending with E at the end. So it's both for the masculine and for feminine. It's neutral. Okay, now we have le rose and la rose. Okay, so we still have it as a masculine and feminine. Okay, so we have le rose, la rose, which is color what? Pink. Now we have le noir, la noir, which is color black. Now we have le brun, la brune. Now, le brun, it can also be called marron, okay? Le marron, la marron, which is what? Brown, color brown. Now we have le violet, la violet, which is color purple. Okay, please take note of that. Now we have le clair, la clair, okay? So, le clair, la clair is not a color, but if you want to say sky blue, you say bleu clair. Okay, so any of the colors you want to say, you know, light, like a light blue, light green, light, so you add clair to it. Then if you want to say dark blue and all that, you say foncé. Okay, so now you want to say navy blue in French, you say le bleu foncé. Okay, so I just added that vocabulary there. Then we also have l'or, which is gold. Though gold is not a color, okay, but some people say, I want a, you know, a bag that is gold, okay. two-letter words, O-R, l'or, which is gold. Then we have l'argent, which is what? Silver. So that's with our colors. Okay, so please, with these colors, you should be able to make what we call les phrases en français, as they make sentences in French with these colors. Okay, so, and now please take note, like I always tell my students, now you want to say the red bag. Now in French, you now say, it's just like as if you want to say the bag red. So in French, you say le sac rouge. If you want to do mot à mot, what we call mot à mot, word for word, okay, so you see that it's not blend. Okay, so that's why you need someone to teach you the French language, okay, because it's not the same with English, okay. So we have the red bag, then in French we say le sac rouge. So please take note of that. Okay, so now, so that's how you can form your sentences. Okay, in French, so you put the colors behind the noun. Okay, please take note of that. Mais I hope it's taken. Merci beaucoup. So now we're going to be going quickly to les vêtements, which means clothing. Okay, so now les vêtements in French, okay, means clothing, like I said before. So now we have here une chemise. Une chemise means what? A shirt. Now we have un pantalon. And pantalon is what? Trousers. In America, we say pants, okay? So, trousers. Then, un jean, that's what? A jean. Now we have une jupe, which means what? A skirt. Now we have un corsage, which is what? A blouse, okay? So, corsage, sometimes you can also say blues, okay? It still means blouse. Now we have une robe. Une robe means what? A gown. We have un pain, which means what? Wrapper. We have enfoulade, okay? Enfoulade, which means what? Head tie, okay? Then we have invest, okay? So invest is like a jacket, okay? Then un imprimable is like a raincoat or a kind of cloth that we wear during winter, okay? So un imprimable, rain, and then during winter, okay? So, you know, to, you know, cover our bodies very well. Okay, so now we have un t-shirt. Okay, it's almost the same thing in English. Now we have un pullover, so la même chose. It's almost the same thing in English. We have pullover in English too. It's the same thing as pullover. Okay, now we have une cravate, which is what? A tie. Okay, then we have un écharpe, which is a scarf. Okay, so then we have un mouchoir. Un mouchoir is what? Like a handkerchief. Okay, so use it to clean the sweat on your face. Okay, we mentioned foulard here, so there's no need for this. Now we have un sac à main. Un sac à main is handbag. So you know the importance of clothing, what we, you know, to use to clothe ourselves, to make that, we teach our students that clothing are used to cover ourselves, okay, cover our bodies, and also clothing are also to add beauty to ourselves, okay. Like someone will always say, dress the way you want to be addressed. Okay, so your dressing, you know, speaks more about you, who you are also. Okay, so we have un sac à main, that's handbag. But normally you can say there are different types of bags you can use. You have school bag, sac de collier, okay, that's school bag, okay, sac à main, that's handbag for ladies. Okay, so now we have un parapluie. Okay, un parapluie is an umbrella. Some can also use it as part of dressing and all that. So we have in costume, that's a suit, okay, that's complete, you know, dressing. That you have trouser suits, you have skirt suits, as in top and the top and the skirt and the trousers. Okay, now we have a shorts, as in French we still say shorts. Shorts is still shorts, as in shorts, a short sneaker. Then we have ceinture, okay, and ceinture, that's a belt. Then we have un chapeau, okay, so that's a hat. Then we have un casquette, that's a face cap, okay. Then we have des lunettes, which is what, glasses, okay. We have two types of glasses. We have, you know, we have the one we use to read, you know, or to see well, those that cannot, you know, see well, or those that are aged that, you know, cannot read very well. So we also have a the lunettes, the souliers. Okay, so sunglasses. Now we have une montre, which is what? A wristwatch. Then we have un collier, which is, our chain. Then we have un bague, that's ring. Okay, so when you get married, you use your un bague. Then we have the bijou. Okay, so the bijou is, jewelries. Okay, then we have the caleçon. The caleçon is on this. Okay, then we have the chaussure. Okay, chaussure is what shoe everyone, needs to put on their chaussure when they are going out. Okay, then you can also use the sandal, though the sandal is not there. Okay, you see it on the screen. Okay, sandals, these are sandals. Okay, then you have the boots. Okay, so the boots is what? Boots. Okay, then we have the chaussettes. The chaussettes is what? Socks. Okay, so now we're going to be adding more vocabularies. Okay, vocabulary that you can use concerning dressing. Okay, now we have habit. Now habit is to dress. Okay, habit. Je m'habille bien. Okay, I dress well. Okay, then we also have for example, you can make a sentence say, je porte un pantalon. I'm putting on a trouser. Okay, elle porte un pantalon. Il porte un pantalon. Okay, so he's putting on a trouser. Okay, so now you can say, maybe you go to the boutique and you can say, if we say ça, you can try this, you can put this on. You know, if we say le jupe, try the skirt. If we say le pantalon, if we say la robe. Okay, you can try, the gown. So these are words you can use, in the boutique. Then there are also some other words you can use, like le coton. Okay, so you want to know whether the word is, made up of, the material is made up of, cottons. Okay, then you have cuir. Okay, cuir is a leather. You want to know whether that's the material you want to buy is made up of. Est-ce que c'est en cuir? Okay, so est-ce qu'ils ont en lin? Okay, you know whether it's made up of leather. So maybe the bag you want to buy or the clothing. Okay, est-ce qu'ils ont en lin? Okay, so is it made up of leather? Okay, so many of it like that. Then we have a nylon. Okay, that's also a part of material. Then we also have, like I told you, cotton. That's what cotton material. Then we also have in French, tissu is also material, okay? So as you want to buy material, say, je veux un tissu, quel tissu que tu veux? Est-ce que c'est en laine, bien, est-ce que c'est coton? Then you want to buy some material, is it made of leather, is it made of cotton, and all that, okay? So please don't forget that tailleur is what? A tailor. And what does a tailleur do? He could, okay? He sews. Le tailleur could. So the tailor sews what? Clothing, okay, or clothes. Okay, so now there are also some words you can use concerning clothing. Okay, where mon sac? Where mon sac bleu? Where is my blue bag? Where mon pantalon rouge? Where is my red trouser? Okay, so you can ask for your clothing and add the colors to it. You can try this at home. Before you know it, you're already speaking the French language, so you can see that's why we try to make the French, very, very simple for you. Okay, so somewhere you can go to the boutique and, ask for your clothes, okay? Quelle couleur, what color? Quelle couleur que tu veux? What color do you want? Est-ce que c'est rouge? Est-ce que c'est bleu? Okay, so please try and make efforts, make sentences with the following colors and the clothing. Okay, so you can see the handouts written on the screen. So we try to make this friend very easy for you. The handout is there before you, okay, and even with the pronunciation guide, in order for it to be simple for you, please always try to speak the language as you learn, because language dies, really. If you don't speak it, it dies. So please take notes of this and try to practicing, and in no time, I bet you'll be able to speak the French language. Okay, so we call it a day here. So please try to subscribe to my channel, okay? Make your positive comments, you know, try to like, okay, and all that. Okay, so we've come to the end of our lesson, our bright colors. Okay, merci beaucoup. Also, Vera.
Je me baladais sur l'avenue, le cœur ouvert à l'inconnu. J'avais envie de dire bonjour à n'importe qui.